back to more Knights of the Old Republic. Time to turn this quest in. We cleared the taint at the Grove. I don't think we cleared it in the way that they had intended. They probably wanted me to save that chick there, Johanna, but yeah, being the typical dumbasses that they are, they didn't know who they were sending. You don't send me to save
Giovanni
someone.
Giovanni was a dear companion to me for many years. We spent many nights together alone under the stars. That will never happen again.
Oh, damn.
To you. Curse the council for sending you, of all people, to speak to her. Could you have done nothing else?
She had it coming, trust me.
She had it coming, did she? She had it coming?
That's right.
The I knew deserved more than this. She deserved more from the council and more from you. You did not even try, did you?
No.
You that Johanni might have been saved, that she might be worth saving. I should kill you for what you've done.
Try.
And yet, I can't.
Go ahead and try.
I'm a Jedi, and we are sworn to protect all. Even the likes of you.
Because you're fucking
get
dumb.
Out of my sight. The very thought of the council and of you makes me ill.
It's not my fault. You're on the... Yeah, fucking morons. Hey, don't get mad at me, okay? The council's the one that sent me to do that. They should have known it. All of their infinite wisdom, how that was going to play out. You send the evil Sith guy to cleanse the Grove. I do apologize for killing your lesbian lover, though. I feel bad about it. If I had remembered that, if I had known that, I probably would have let her live. Alright, let's get crystals. Let's see. So the one in the middle determines the color. It already has red in it. Damn, I don't have purple. I have blue, yellow. I've got two rubits. So these are the colors that I've got. This one's in the stick now. These are the other three that I've got. So I can dual wield blues here if I want. Which I don't want to do because I'm evil. I've got two rubats. Attack one, damage one. Bondor. So my red saber is now the good saber. Oh, I can dual wield reds. Apparently I've got more red crystals, 10 of them. Alright, then fuck the blue one. Got a rubit. Fortunately, I don't have anything to go in the other side, so this saber will be a bit weaker than the other one. Melee. I might start selling my melee upgrade parts, to be honest, because lightsabers don't use the same thing as those. So unless I pull Zalber out of retirement, you know, I won't be using those anymore. Let's see, Mission Veil is currently wearing that. Here's all of our guns. Still don't have that part. Tempted to yank those out, though, because I'm probably not going to use them anymore. Yeah, I'm going to continue using, I'm getting my other lady back in a moment, so. Yeah. There we go. So I'm going to walk right up in here with two fucking red sabers now. They're going to be like, where'd you get that other one? I'm like, I just got that shit. Like, you already put red on there? Yeah, that's right. Nothing suspicious about that, by the way. These master dumbass Jedis still can't figure out that just maybe I'm not, you know, a good guy. You know, just maybe. Maybe I'm not the good guy that they think. But no, they're so fucking brain dead that they can't see an obvious goddamn evil dark Jedi right in front of their face.
If you have questions, you should direct.
Right, okay. Well, who we want to talk to? She could be saved. I just didn't do it.
High hopes for her in the future. In every heart, there is some means of redemption. Could you find none in Johnny?
Lie. Oh, I forget how many dark side points you can get for lying to these dumbasses. She was too evil to ever come back. That's not true. I'm too evil to never come back. Although that's probably not true either. I could probably be persuaded. It'd have to come from Mission Valor, Bastila, of course. I don't think anyone else is going to have much luck.
Perhaps that was the case. It is most regrettable indeed. Heed her example. All are susceptible to the lure of the dark side. We must always remain.
I wasn't lured by the dark side. I was just in it.
And inform him that the
I am the dark side.
I think you may be nearing the end of your apprenticeship.
Yeah, I'm well on my way towards that dark side path, huh? Bunch of fucking morons, I tell you.
You have cleansed the grove of its dark taint, but at great cost. Juhani was a most promising student, and could one day have been strong in the Force. Do not dismiss what happened to her, however. Juhani was both dedicated and true to the ideals of the Order, yet she was still vulnerable to the lure of the dark side. Keep this in mind always.
So am I.
And do not forsake the path of the light.
I was never on the path of the light.
Or should I say, congratulations, Padawan. You have proven yourself worthy of joining the Jedi. Let me be the first to welcome you as a full-fledged member of our Order.
I don't want to be a member. You can take that title and shove it. Put it right next to Joanna's corpse. So I used to like Johanna, but I can only slot 2 party members, and I have 3 that I like. Or you haven't seen the 3rd one yet, but I'm gonna get him later. Right now, I have 2 that I like. Let me put it that way. We don't have room for Johanna, and I don't need another meleeing lightsaber guardian tank. That's what I'm making. I'm doing that myself anyway. And she's another goody two shoes character that's gonna cry about everything that I do.
Yeah.
No thanks. I don't need her. Skills. This guy doesn't hardly even need treat injury, just sitting around. He just Wolverines his health back, because he's basically a cheater. Kind of like Zalbar, where Zalbar is overpowered, so is Candorous, because Candorous auto-heals. No one else will do that. But there is an implant that you can find somewhere in the game. If you equip it, you get a health regen. I don't know if it's at level 2 or 3 or what, but it'll give you a health regen, so that's pretty decent. I haven't found it yet, however, so I don't know what else to tell you. He's already got heavy armor. Got his max implants. That would be nice. Let's go with maximum toughness. Even more health for his overpowered ass. 129. Got her as well. Level 9. All she gets are skills. Ding, ding, ding. She can't get a treat injury. Since that's a secondary, she can only get it every other level and it costs as much. Secondaries you end up spending the same amount of points into, but you're only getting half the effects, which is a real waste. Basically, you'll spend the same amount of points into them, but you'll have half as much. In the long run. See the problem? Say, this is max right now, and she has it at 6th. Whereas the primary ones are capped at 13. And that 6 right there, that was 12 points. It took 12 points to get that to a 6, whereas this is 13 for 13. It's a waste. But I think I'll just let her keep her other points. I'm keeping her around for security, which is useful. Actually, you don't need security in the game, because you can just bash open all of the doors and containers. So this right here, pretty much a wasted skill. I could just stop getting it, but whatever. Stealth I'm not going to bother with.
Yes?
Alright, give me my robe and let's get the fuck out of here.
If you have questions.
I don't know who to talk to. We have a ring of idiots here. Let's go
Our
with Midget.
Is now complete, Padawan. And perhaps now it is time we dealt with the matter of the dream you and Bastila share.
All right.
When we heard of the ruins in your dreams, Master Dorok recognized it as one of a series of ancient structures here on Tantooine. This one in particular lies to the east of this enclave. We sent a Jedi to investigate, but he has not returned.
Ah.
Perhaps sending him in the first place was a mistake. The Force is guiding you through your visions. It may be that exploring the ruins is a task tied to your destiny. That is why the Council has now decided you should be the one to investigate this. The secrets to stopping Malak may be hidden within those ruins. You must investigate them and find what Revan and Malak were looking for.
Well, I'm the one that gets shit done. So, what happened to that other loser?
We do not know. That is one of the things you must investigate. We fear the worst.
Fear leads to the dark side. What can you tell me about Bastila?
Bastila will be a great Jedi someday. Even among the masters of the Council.
She's fine now.
To find one so skilled in the art of battle meditation. Bastila was there when Revan was slain. Did you know that?
Yeah, I knew it. I mean, I know everything. These Jedi are hiding some big secrets from you that they are literally not telling you. But this here, my character knew that. Karth mentioned it.
Bastila herself does not like to talk about it. She was accompanying the strike team that confronted Revan when the Dark Lord was destroyed. Her role in the death of such a promising young Jedi as Revan upset her greatly. But Bastila knew she had to set her personal feelings aside.
She's right over there.
The galaxy. The Force is strong with her now. And without her skill in battle meditation, we would have lost this war long ago. The way ahead will be difficult for young Bastila. And for you. But you must draw strength from each other. May the Force be with you.
The Force will be with Bastila, I can tell you that. But she has to share it with Vale. And, damn, I didn't take the gear off of Candorous yet. Oh. Alright, well, I'll slot Candorous first. Then maybe I could switch.
I demand justice!
There we go.
The Central family is a blight upon Dantooine. They must be punished. The Council will look into this matter, Mr. Mitali. You must be patient. Your accusations have no proof. And we do not want you stirring up trouble with the Sandrals. If there is some mistake.
Mistake? My son Shen is missing. How can there be any doubt the Sandrals are to blame?
There are other possible explanations for your son's disappearance.
Ah, you Jedi are good for nothing but talk. I shall only wait so long before I take action on my own.
As dangerous as the threat from Darth Malak and the Sith may be, we Jedi cannot simply abandon our other responsibilities.
Haven't you already?
The Council has promised, Alan Mitali, we will look into a son's disappearance. Should you have time, Padawan, you may want to investigate this matter.
You guys have already abandoned everyone else in on here. You not... There's like Mandalorian Raiders, Cat Hound killing everybody. But yeah, okay. By the way, are you aware of the fact that your eyes don't blink in unison? I think that might be a medical issue. I have more important things to do.
Your study and training are important, of course. But the Jedi are not a cloistered order. Our influence and teachings must spread beyond the walls of our academies.
It is in the real world that we truly prove ourselves worthy of the title Jedi. You would do well to remember this, young Padawan.
The task has its own importance. It may also serve to divert our minds for a short time. Something which carries its own rewards.
That's what I say every night. Damn it. Wait, hold on. Party selection, okay.
Huh?
Alright, Candorous. Give me all my shit back. Taking that blaster too. I'll give you your clothes. Just just so you don't have to stand around my ship in your panties.
What can I do?
I don't want my ladies getting distracted. From me, that is. Tributes. I think I'll be putting that right on over into strength. I don't see a better place to put it. Her dex is already through the damn roof at 18. Don't ever put points into these others. Once you've are, you know, you put points into these four at character level up. You don't put them into a character who's already created. That's stupid. The problem is that these are not retroactive. The game will not credit you for the levels that you didn't have them. So, like, if I get halfway through the game and I put Constitution up, it's not going to back pay me for the health for all of the levels I've done gotten. You need to have the Constitution up front per level. The same can be said about skill points and force points. Force points come from both of these. This one's skill points, that one's health. So don't invest these four here. Only put points into them at the start of the game, and that's it. After that, focus on these two, because there's no penalty. It doesn't matter if you get these two early on or later, so you can really tank your strength and dex at the start. Focus on these early on, because you can put your five additional points into these later. And we're going for strength, because she needs more. Skills. Just go for awareness and treat injury. She can't do anything else. Powers. I really want this droid. My character is going to be evil. I'm not getting light side powers. That's what this is. She is going to be my anti-droid nuker. I like how it says only the main character can select this, but she has it. Does this shit affect the entire party, or just her? No. We want group buffs on her, so this heals the group, this buffs. Entire party, that's what I want to see. Damn, party, man, all entire party. So this one affect the entire, so does that one. Alright, let's get the droid. Light side Jedis, or good Jedis, they lack good offensive. Get the droid. Destroy droid. You want this. Some of the toughest enemies in the game are going to be droids. Oh wow, I get another one. Okay. Just get both of those. Feats. Really tempted to get implant level 1, but I still don't have any really impressive implant. Let's go for 2 weapon fighting. Max that out. Get her damage up there. It's called damage. Let's get this. Oh, nice. Look at that. This means she can shield the entire party. Grants immunity to poisons and diseases for 2 minutes. Absorbs 15 points of damage from sonic, fire, cold, electrical. And that should be modified by our stats. Another point. Or another level. They're back paying me for the level that she wasn't here for. Alright, she's already got throw lightsaber, so I'm really tempted to get another one. Give her another. Let's let her get throw lightsaber. She can throw her saber. That'll be fun. All right, we got Bastila back, and the items that she was hoarding off me. By the way, I got a Jedi robe. Jedi robes have almost no defensive bonus. But you can wear them without an armor perk. although you still have your armor perks from your main class, but they have a really high dex bonus, so you don't have to worry about that anymore. That's why, if you want to be a tank with heavy armor, then you sink your dex, but if you want to be a Jedi and wear a robe, it's helpful to have dex, because with the robe you have a high dex bonus. Not limited by that. Now, I could jack this sword off her. I could use this double-bladed lightsaber now and give her something else, but she can keep it. If I'm going to be bringing her anyway, she may as well swing it. She's got 15 strength. Another point of strength. Oh, okay. What do I have? Strength plus two. Let's switch her to the just fooling around here for a minute. She could use more fortitude. Where's the fortitude? That one. She doesn't need more reflex, though. Give her more fortitude. There we go. Look at that. How's my shield coming? Oh, I only got one use on that. We need to get rid of it. Candorous. You've been stripped. Good. We need you to be stripped. Might want to try and get implants on her at some point. She can get one of these. She already has this, though. A Sentinel has several immunities automatically. She gets immunity to fear. I think it's fear, stun, and paralyze. It might not be mind affecting. There's one. Fear, stun, paralyze. I guess she doesn't have mind affecting, so yeah, she could use that. But that's level 2. She doesn't even have level 1. She doesn't have a robe, by the way. She just has basic clothing. I now have a robe. It gives me one armor, which is weak, but it's one armor versus no armor. And the max dex bonus is so high, I'll probably never get plus 8 dex. I've only got plus... You see this number right here? That can get up to 8. I only have it at 1. Even hers is only at 4. The Jedi robe allows for a dex bonus of plus 8. She's only at 4. She's at 18 dex. She only has half of the maximum bonus. So yeah, you don't ever have to worry about capping your dex wearing a Jedi robe, basically. Alright, goodbye, Candorous. Give me my other lady friend back. Wow, that is a damn good item. I forgot how much I spoiled you, Mission. Alright, she's got my good belt. Plus 3 fortitude, but her fortitude is really low, so she needs it more than Bastila. Bastila's already heavily defensive. I have so many good vests here. Damn. I didn't give you an implant. Cam energy shield. Alright.
What?
You can get a Sith robe. You can get a dark robe that's black to wear through the game. But I can't get that until after I get off of Dantooine. It's pretty much the same as the Jedi version, but it's nice and black. How much money do I have, by the way? 5,000. Alright, so with the two farms, there's two rivaling farms, and they don't like each other. One of them, the guy who just came in there, threatened to go kill the other one. He's saying that his son is missing, and obviously he blames the other the other farm. Oh, the lady's gone. The lady with her... She had a speeder here, and it's gone. So, the first thing we want to do is go meet with both of the other... Or both of the farms. The droids will let us in now if we tell them that we come on behalf of the Conclave to investigate. But they're basically... One of them is going to say that his son is missing, and he accuses the other farm of having something to do with it. And if you remember that corpse that I've been mentioning, the corpse that I've been looking for, you'll probably see where this is going. I was hoping to already find that corpse. I don't remember where it is. It's probably out in the world somewhere now. I'm scanning my brain files. I remember it being in a hilly location, not a flat one like this. It's not gonna be here. But there's a few areas that are quite similar, so... I'd like to find it before I go into either of the farms and talk with their leaders. Or owners, or whatever. It's an interesting quest, really. We also need to find the rest of the Mandalorians, which will have been spawned since we went and talked to that guy. Cat hounds. So if you don't want Basila in your party, you can zoink her double-bladed lightsaber, and then you can use the crystal to change the color. So you can change it to red if you want. But I'm going to use Basila, so I may as well just let her swing it herself. Hey, guess what it is? Oh, look at that. Verifying headband. Chani shield, Chani light armor cardio package. Can you heal me, babe? Heal us up. Alright, let's try and find that journal. This is the diary of Cassis Sandriel, amateur archaeologist. It details his efforts to discover the source of the ancient ruins found across the surface of Dantooine. Upon reading it, you gather that he had found some correlation between the ruins and something called the Rack. What are these others? Jarg went missing in Sector B. Right.
Yes?
So I found the corpse I was looking for. Let's see if we can find the rest of the Mandalorians. Hi.
You should...
That's where the grove was. I wonder if that's where the Mandalorians are hiding. No, it doesn't look like it. Did I check that other corpse? No. Okay. So even if you're playing a dark side character, you might want to keep Johanna because you can get a triple Jedi team by keeping her, But I think two lightsaber characters is enough. We gotta have someone shooting. I don't see a need to have a third Jedi. Her class is Guardian, which is the one I'm already rolling. She uses a single lightsaber with dueling. Which I robbed it. I robbed that lightsaber off of her. I'm swinging it. Ah, here we go. Shit, stop.
I'm here.
Show you why. That's why. Shield us. Give me this one too. Can I stack these? Alright.
Ah, so this is the meddler. You have caused us far too much trouble for a mere Jedi. I will add your head to those of the other Jedi I have killed and take yet another lightsaber for my own.
Lightsaber, you
now
say?
You will know why the Mandalorians are feared.
We'll see about that. Boy. Shit, he just took my ass down. He wasn't fucking joking. He just took another one of us down. Oh boy. That's not good. Run away! Mission Vale is not... We just got our asses handed to us. Are they chasing her? I might need to leave the zone. Stop following her. Oh, can I transit? Well, I hope you're not telling me I'm supposed to fucking die. F. That guy whooped my ass. Train fucked up. How'd I get my people back, damn it? It's been so long since I wiped, I can't remember what the fuck happens. The character's sitting over there fucking dead. She's not gonna kill these guys. He's at low health, though. Did you already throw out all my grenades? Oh, fuck, man, this ain't gonna work. She is gonna get goddamn raped. It's all up to you, Mission. Oh boy, and that put me back at the main menu. Shit. You got our first wipe of the run. God, I haven't saved in like half an hour. Because I've been doing it between episodes. I just got wiped the fuck out. My characters are sitting over there dead. He's camping our corpse. I can't leave the area because I don't have our... Alright, I have an idea, but it's gonna be very fucking cowardly. No, run. Run away. Wow. He's chasing me forever. I'm running faster than him, though. Thank you. Damn. Shit. Medkit. Medkit. Told you to medkit, not shoot. Medkit. Oh no, that's bad. Oh boy. Well, he was alone. I might have to do, like, a whole fucking section again. Which would suck. Wait a minute. 4 minutes. 12 minutes. I'm loading a save. This is an auto save. Oh boy, put me back here. Fuck. Wasting my goddamn time. All because that Mandalorian douchebag is so stupidly overpowered, he just whacked my character in like one hit. He better have some good shit on him. What do you mean I must gather my party? Are they not right here? Keep up, bitch. Get up here. All grounds. I think this time I'll just go to the Sandrill first. So where is the Sandrill grounds? Path south, path south. I can't remember exactly how to do this quest with these Joker. Oh, here it is, Sandrill Grounds. Alright. See, I think I'll talk to this one first. I come on behalf of the Jedi Council.
The Council? If you are here because of Shen Makari's disappearance, you are wasting your time. The Sandals are not involved. This is nothing but a Makari witch hunt.
I am not in league with the Batalis, but I must speak to Nurek.
Nurek left orders he was not to be disturbed, but given the circumstances, I will make an exception. Go into the main hall. Nurek will meet with you there.
All right.
I have been informed by my protocol droid that you wish to speak to me.
I am here on behalf of the Jedi Council. Forgive my breathing mask and creepy looking face. I am complete, normal, decent, nice Jedi who wishes only to do good.
I brought my family here to find peace and safety, not to be harassed and treated like common criminals. Your council has no authority here, and I respectfully ask you to leave this property at once.
Jedi are renowned for their fairness and pursuit of justice. There is nothing to fear from us, unless you have something to hide.
I trust you will show yourself out. If not, my security droids will be sure to deal with you.
Threatening me is not a good idea. Uh-oh. This is his daughter, I think.
You are here from the council, are you not? Looking for Shen Metale?
Who are you?
My name is Rahasia. Nurek is my father. He has not been himself since Cassis disappeared.
Cassis, okay.
He is mad with grief, and he is convinced the Metales are responsible. He's not thinking rationally.
Oh, I think I remember now. Both of their sons is missing. and both of them accuses the other farm of being responsible. But we already found Cass's corpse. Although because I reloaded, my character has not found the corpse yet, so I can't mention it. I have to go get the corpse again before I could mention it to someone. So we know where the missing son for this farm is, but the guy who went to the conclave is not from this farm. He was from the other farm, and he said his son was missing, and he's blaming this farm here. Both of them are missing their sons, and we only have a corpse for one of them.
My father is a good man. When my mother died, he raised me and my brother by himself. He loves his children, and we love him. I just don't want you to judge him too harshly.
Judge him? What has your father done?
You must understand that father has been under a terrible strain. I have no wish to disobey him. There are matters where even my father's authority is not absolute.
Quit stalling and get to the point.
My father has kidnapped Shen.
Ah, there it is.
He's holding him prisoner here in the compound. He feels this is a way to get back at the Metales, a way to get even for the disappearance of my brother Cassus.
I see. Well, there is the answer we seek. The Jedi Council should be informed of this at once.
No. Since Cassus went missing, my father has become unstable. He might hurt him if you do that. He no longer even cares if the Metales are responsible for what happened to Cassus. I'm afraid my father will simply kill Shen out of a mad, misguided lust for vengeance.
Why are you telling me all this?
Shen is an innocent victim in all this. My father is not a bad man, but his grief has driven him to madness. He must be stopped. Please, find Shen and rescue him before my father does something he will regret forever. I would take you to the prison, but I cannot let my father see me with you. Take this key. It will open an unguarded door at the rear of the estate. You and Shen can make your escape through there. There are many security droids guarding the halls. Please hurry. You are Shen's only hope.
Why do you care about Shen?
Shen and I, we have been taught by our families to hate each other, just for being related to our fathers. But I met Shen alone one day in the city. Away from his father, and Shen was so charming, so sweet. He didn't care at all that I was a Sandral. He just accepted me for who I was.
Okay.
No reservations. We talked and met again over months and fell in love. My brother Cassus met him too.
I like how she put that.
They were beginning to become friends, but then this whole mess had to happen. Please find Shen and free him. You are my only hope.
Help me, Drain Blood. You are my only hope. If I am your only hope, then you are fucked. So the other father went to the conclave to ask for help because his son is missing. His son is being held prisoner in this one. But their son is also missing. So you see the convoluted situations they put you to in these games. Alright. So I could go ahead and break into the back of that building there, but I'm not going to do it yet. This quest has a number of outcomes, depending on what all you do. First, I'm going to take revenge on that fucking Mandalorian that got me killed. Time to spam my drain life. The spell is my namesake. Damn calf hounds. I might have to put my armor on. Alright. This time, planting a goddamn save right here.
What?
bastards.
I'm here. Huh?
Sure.
Cover my ass in goddamn buffs.
So this is the...
I will add...
Alright, I think I should try and get all these other guys first. No, go for the other guy. Not him. Damn you, this one. She's getting ripped. Yes, I know. Damn the damage that this guy has. Holy fucking shit. Just heal. We got him. Heal again. We got him.
Sure.
Pause and heal. Not fucking laughing now. Had some good shit, by the way. Two lightsabers. I don't know if they have the upgrade items in them, but I can also get the colors. That's it. All right. So the main quest here is to go to that cave, where the temple that I couldn't get in before, that's where we need to go. However, I'm going to do the farm quest with the two farms, Atali grounds. Oh right, the body was right here, that's good. Or wait, was it? Where's that corpse? Slight problem. I can't remember where that corpse was. This isn't it. It was a corpse. Oh, that is it. This is it. The corpse is gone. Alright, now that I found that corpse, I want to not tell them about it, basically.
Yes?
It's like, yeah, I found your I found the corpse. I found the son, one of the missing sons, but I'm not going to tell them about it. You know, dark side and all. Her outfit is so fucking gay. It's gayer than your lightsaber color.
Yes?
My character's starting to look like a Chaos Marine. Alright, that's the front door.
This is Private Front.
Come on behalf of the Jedi Council. So this is the guy, that's the guy who came to see us.
You have come from the Jedi Council. Master Matali wishes to speak with you. I will inform him that you are here. Remain at this location until he arrives.
So this one wants to talk to me. All right. His guards seem to be better armed than the other guys. These guys got guns.
My protocol droid tells me you are here on behalf of the Council. I was beginning to think my demands had been ignored. though I think your time would be better spent interrogating the Sandrils as to the whereabouts of my son, Shen.
Why are you so certain the Sandrils are to blame? The character looks so evil. Look at him, he's like a corpse. It's great.
Many years ago, I brought my family here to Dantooine to escape the crush of humanity on the core worlds. Soon after we settled here, the Sandrils arrived, and they have been a plague upon my house ever since. The injustices the Sandrils have committed against the Metallis are far too numerous to name. But the Council is well aware of our many disputes. Recently, I discovered several Sandril droids trespassing on my land.
What were they doing here?
I have no idea what nefarious purpose lay behind their arrival. My own assassination, perhaps? Destruction of my property? Maybe a simple spy mission? I wasn't about to find out. My own security droids destroyed the invaders. Not a single one survived. It was shortly after this incident that Shen, my only son and heir to the Metalli estate, vanished. Obviously, Nurik, the unscrupulous head of the Sandril clan, has abducted my son in retaliation for the destruction of his droids.
That's not quite true. His droids were looking for his son. And now he thinks that he never found his son, and now he thinks this family has his son, so he took their son. So, you see how this is going? The reality, though, is that the first guy's son got eaten by a calf hound. That's pretty much the size of it.
The only resolution possible is the immediate return of my son. Why does the council insist on stalling? The life of my son is at stake. Is it possible? Yes, of course. Now I understand. I am a man of the world, Jedi. I know how things are done. I will make a contribution of 1,000 credits to the council in exchange for...
Now you're speaking my language.
I will present the credits directly to you, of course. Whether the council ever learns of this donation is completely up to you.
Let's go. Well, why not? Make it 2,000, fucker.
2,000? Your greed is outstripped only by your utter lack of any sense of proportion, Jedi.
2,000. Even if you would pay such a fee, what could you possibly need so many credits for?
For that,
the shit on the vendor.
Enough droids to destroy the entire Sandril estate. 2,000 is out of the question. Nevertheless, my offer still stands.
Yeah, he's not biting.
For Shen's safe return. Know, however, that I will not sit idly by much longer. Eventually, I will take whatever action is necessary to rescue my son, including raising the entire Sandril estate. Until you find Shen, Jedi, we have nothing further to discuss. I suggest you hurry south to their estate, lest I take matters into my own hands.
All right. Dark side point. Oh, goody. Well, this guy is somewhat correct. His son is at the other farm, kidnapped. But the other guy is wrong. That guy's son is not at this farm. Yeah, I don't think you get into this guy's house. Just the other one. Alright, well, I wasn't sure I wasn't sure what decision I was gonna make for this to come out, but this guy just offered me 1,000 credits, so I think I know what I'm gonna do. You got Bastila over here being like, what could you possibly need money for? Meanwhile, shit on the vendor costs 7,000 or 8,000 goddamn credits. Shut the fuck up. I need that money. Okay? I only got 5,500 right now. I need my fucking money. There's something on one of those vendors for 8,500 credits that I want to get. I forgot what it was, but I remember the price. I don't have 8,500 credits, so yeah, I need money. The Jedi aren't gonna fucking pay me to do what they sent me to do. I may as well do my own thing. This guy's gonna pay me. The Sandril the Sandro guy, by the way, did not offer to give you any money. Neither did the girl. That guy offered to give you the money. So, yeah. He just bought my services. This is the... Is that the front door or the back door? The front door should have a droid. This has to be the front door. I don't know which one of them is the back door. I think it's this one. It looks a bit more discreet. So if you play your cards right in here, I think you can break in and get the guy's son. But, oh, well, never mind. Can I loot this shit? Great. Hi. You got stun droid, right? Did I not get that shit? Stun droid, disable droid. Oh, it's over the mob. Okay. Just like that. And you?
Yes.
Once again, the council is going to be like, we sent you to negotiate, and it turned into a fucking bloodbath. And I'm going to be like, well, what'd you expect? You sent the Sith warrior serial killer to do it. It's like, yeah. Of course it's gonna, everyone's gonna die. You sent me to do it. Slice the computer. North hallway. Nothing. Corrupt patrol droid targeting computer. How many spikes do I have? 6? Oh, fuck it. South hallway. Security room. That's us. Do not overload that. Yeah. I hope I don't make that mistake again. Alright, we'll overload that one. Ow. That one had droids in it. Repair room. I think that droid on the left, I might be able to mooch. Bug it, though. Overload. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's the one I was just on. Oh, look, we got another one. Don't want the map. Experience. Guy's probably thinking, like, what the fuck is going on? All my droids are blowing up. These people are sad and pathetic. I'm surrounded by goddamn droids. Honestly, though, they need to just get it on already. You have one guy with an army of droids, and you have another guy with an army of droids. Just get it on already. I'm gonna rob this place for everything it's worth. I don't think I can go in the other place. I think we can only go into this one. That's why the guy came outside, because... The inside of the other one probably doesn't exist in the game files, so the guy came outside to talk to you. The inside of his place even exists. Free landmine for me. Door.
Gotcha. Simple.
Hey, look who it is.
Who are you? What do you want with me? Are you working for my father?
Anyone tell you I asked too many questions? Now sit down and shut up.
As you wish. I have no quarrel with you.
Yes?
Whoops. I thought the conversation would keep going.
Who are you?
Alright, let's go with the first one. I'm here to rescue you.
Rescue me? No. I won't leave. It's too dangerous.
I'll protect you, Shin. Let's go.
It's not my own safety I'm concerned about. I'm worried about the fate of Nurik's daughter, Rahasia. She's been trying to convince her father to release me ever since I was captured. If I escape, Nurik will think Rahasia is to blame. Nurik is insane with grief over the loss of his son, Cassus. If I leave with you, it is Rahasia who will suffer. I cannot allow that.
Alright, he had a thing for the girl. You have the son from one household and the daughter from the other household and starting to hit it up. So now he got captured by the girl's father and imprisoned in the house with the same chick. He doesn't even want to be released. What if we take Rahasia with us?
If you can convince Rahasia to escape with us, I will accompany you. Though I do not know if she'd be willing to turn her back on her home and family. Who could imagine a Sandral doing such a thing for the sake of a Mitali? But if she will not go, then I too shall stay. I would rather face my own death than have her face her father's wrath because I escaped.
Why do your families hate each other so much?
My father thinks the Sandrals are thieves and liars who followed him here to Dantooine just to steal what he has earned for himself. My father is an egotist and can be violent at times, but I think he still cares for me. Rahasia's father seems to be falling into the same pattern as mine. They're both too unreasonable to be talked to about the other. I think the only hope Rahasia and I will ever have is if we can escape both of them. Please, find Rahasia and speak to her. Get her to flee this place with me.
I don't remember the correct actions on this quest to get maximum dark side points, so I'm really winging it on this one.
If you can convince... Who could have... I would...
I think for now we need to convince this guy to go.
Thank
you. Alright, this is kind of a mini dungeon though. I'm going to continue exploring. Not family members. Oh, that's the front door. When you come in the front door, you're stuck in that room there. So there's basically nothing in there. Alright, we need to find his girlfriend. And I guess that's her.
What are you doing here? Have you found Shen yet?
I'm trying to rescue Shen, but he won't leave without you, Rahasia. These are pretty much the same choice.
Shen can be so stubborn sometimes. If one of the security droids sees me wandering the halls, Father will get suspicious. I can't risk it. And I know Shen would rather die than leave me here alone to face the wrath of my father. Tell Shen I will meet you outside the gates. I will wait as long as I can, but you must hurry.
You can't wander the halls of your own home? What? Alright. You'll notice that we haven't gotten any light side or dark side points yet. Because we haven't really got to the moral decision yet. A prison key. That opens the door that had Shin in it, but I just broke my way in anyway. One of the flaws of this game is that you don't have to care much about lock picking or keys. Because you can just bash open everything. So it's like, why fucking bother? I already opened this, didn't I? You don't even need, like, that security thing. That security perk. Just break everything. I know there was more rooms where I killed the droids. I think that's something that the developers fixed in the sequel, but I've never played the second game, so I don't really know. to play it one day after recording this one. Well, I've pretty much explored every room. I don't see any corpses for all where all the droids were, so I guess they weren't lootable.
You're back.
Yeah, she promised she would meet us outside the gates.
I pray she is not just telling me what I want to hear, but I will have to take that chance. Hurry then, we must not keep Rahasia waiting.
Oh, I was going to stop there, but it's forcing me outside.
You're safe. Rahasia. Well, thank goodness you managed to escape.
It was all thanks to this kind Jedi that we managed to get this far at all. I thank you, Jedi, for all that you've done for us.
Make sure you find that corpse before you do all of this, because that's in the dialogue options. I mean, even if you don't want to mention the corpse, if you don't mention the corpse to either of them, they'll never know what happened to that other kid, and this family will blame that family for his disappearance. However, if you know about the corpse and you don't mention it, that's more evilness for you, because you're deliberately withholding it. However, if you never find the corpse, then you'll be just as ignorant as they are, and you'll never know where that other kid even was. This is funny. It was all thanks to this kind Jedi that we managed to get this far at all. I thank you, Jedi, for all you have done for us. Shin's father promised me a reward. I'm just gonna say that out loud. That's great.
What? You're just doing this for the reward?
Yeah.
How could you? I thought you...
Cared? No. Look at my face. Am I trustworthy? I'm like fucking Emperor Palpatine over here. Like, yeah, I trust this guy.
There you are, Shen.
Father!
Mr. Matale!
Rahasia!
Father!
Mr. Sandril!
Nurik! Alan! I knew this was all your doing.
Stepladder.
I knew you had captured my son.
You had taken my Cassus from me long
before
that.
No, he didn't.
That. You started it.
Remember.
I don't want to hear any of your excuses. Get revenge for your transgressions.
Alright, here's where our moral choices come into play. So, if you found the corpse and you want a peaceful resolution, you can tell them that the Cath Hounds killed that other kid. And then this one will forgive the other one and let the second kid go and let the girl go. And, you know, they won't shoot each other. However, that's not the ending we want to go with. If you look at the face of my main character, that's not an ending he would go with. His mask almost looks like fucking Darth Malak over here. Why don't you just shoot each other and get it over with?
No, Father, don't do this.
We don't always need to be fighting like this.
It's gone too far for that, Rahasia. Alan has crossed the line one too many times.
For what you've done to me and my family, I will see you dead and rotting in the ground.
So, we still have another choice to stop this. The first two is going to try to stop, talk them out of what I just did. It's given me a second chance to stop this disaster. The third one is going to stay the course. The only way either of you will end this is with blood. Blut.
Are you mad? They will slaughter each other.
No, don't!
That's what I want, Bastila. I'm making this interesting, okay?
Alan, what can we be thinking? How could we have let this go this far? We are at each other's throats now, fighting over our children's lives. When they are old enough to live their own.
Hey, stop.
He is my son. How can he disrespect my wishes like this?
Oh, boy, look at this. They're actually... One of them's actually having second thoughts. We can't have that. So you know what? So that guy behind me, who's having second thoughts, that's actually Nurik. So... We've come for full circle. Now we have to convince them to have the bloodbath. Look at this. You know, Nurik. Alan actually did kill Cassus. A lie. Yes.
What?
What?
No, no. I never did anything to your son. I knew you were lying, you dog. And to think I thought it might not have been you.
so I'll take your son from you!
Father, no! Don't do it!
Die!
Oh, boy. Bam. Whoops. So if you didn't find the corpse, you don't get that option. You have to know that you have to know what happened to the kid. Then you can say that. If you do know what happened to the kid, you can also mention the truth, but I didn't go towards that path. You can tell them that the Cath Hounds killed the kid, and you'll get a peaceful resolution. I don't think there's any avoiding a bloodbath now. I like this one. Don't let him get away with that. That's directed at Alan. Alan's kid just got shot.
Die!
He shoots the girl.
No, Raisha.
That's great.
The master has been injured. Terminate all opposition. Destroy the invader.
Oh boy. Here's your punishment. With the masters dead, the droids turn on you. So we have to whack the droids now. It's a fucking bloodbath. Everybody dies. Dark side points gained. That's what I'm talking about. I'm gonna get back to the Enclave. They're like, what the fuck happened? Everybody's dead. It's like, yeah, what'd you expect? I have some bad news, though. I didn't get the money. If you avoid a bloodbath, you can get the money off that guy, but he has to live. So by having them all kill each other, I lost the credits. The good news, though, is that I got a bunch of dark side points. I got the max. That should have been the maximum amount of dark side points for getting everybody killed. I'm getting close to having this bar capped out. My character looks evil as fuck. His face. Yeah. I like how everyone just trusts me and takes my word at it. It's like, yeah, this is such a trustworthy, super cool guy. Are you sure? Anyway. I think this has gone on long enough, and now that the show is over, I will pick this up in the next one. That was a great show. It's like, it's your son's turn. And they shoot, and he shoots the girl. Don't let him get away with that. And he shoots the girl. Good stuff.